She talked about the three B's of Bill Gates: biology, bytes, and bandwidth. I think we are in several ways extremely lucky people, because we are born at times and live in times where there is tremendous amount of disruption that's occurring in all those three areas: the biology, the bytes, and the bandwidth. There are a number of disruptions that are happening in terms of technology at this point of time, and these technology disruptions have tremendous amount of potential, just to not make sure that people like us, who are all sitting here in this room, to make our lives better, but equally important is to make the lives of people who are at the bottom of the pyramid much, much better. And these technologies, as McKinsey predicts, some 10 of them, are extremely relevant to what we're talking about today. They talk very intensely about IoT, which is Internet of Things. I'll come to a little more detail of that. They talk about 3D printing, where you have printing of even human parts using the right type of material. Tremendous amount of research being done in genomics at this point of time, or automation, robotics, and so on and so forth. So I choose to talk about just one area which I think could have a very strong impact for the people at the bottom of the pyramid, an impact which will probably have in developing nations like India. So for those of you who might not be very familiar what Internet of Things are, so let me get you to a little bit of the background to start with. I'm sure all of us have seen so much of bytes. We have heard about transistors, resistors, capacitors, semiconductors, chips, and so on and so forth. These are nothing but, a miniaturized versions of the same transistors, which for a lack of a better word, people call them as sensors. They don't have a computer built into them, but they have tremendous amount of ability to communicate with each other. And then, when they communicate with each other, they also have ability to automatically connect with other things and exchange information. And we've seen what are the characteristics of these Internet of Things. One is that they have sensing mechanisms built into them. They can sense smell, they can sense color, they can sense vibration, heat, you can name them. All of them are being built into these sensors. The other thing is that they've also become extremely efficient. They don't consume hell of a lot of power. If you look at even the gadget that all of us have in our phones and our handbags and so on and so forth, the iPhone or the Android phone, the Samsung phone and so on and so forth, continue to use it, holding it to your ear heats up in a half an hour's time. So whereas what we see in these efficient devices that have come by, which are the Internet of Things or the sensors, is that they don't have a great amount of power consumption. The third one is that the attribute, they connect with each other. Unlike, you know, you say that I need a dongle which is about 2 inches long and half inch wide. The whole sensor itself could be nothing but quarter inch by quarter inch, but still have that ability to connect with other devices. And these can be many of specialized devices. And then these can be pervasively deployed anywhere in the world. So these are some of the characteristics that we see with the Internet of Things. Before I get down to how do they apply into healthcare. The other thing that we see at this point of time happening around the world is that all of us are familiar with this word called Internet. Internet was huge ways in which we were getting connected together. And honestly, we think that we are in the middle of a third internet wave. The first one, which was more to do fixed line connectivity, where computers talk to each other. Those were the times when we thought we were about a billion people who were connected together. That was the late 90s, or 100 crores of people. But once the mobility came in, and people could get connected from anywhere, at any point of time, from any part of the world, then we saw there were yet another billion people that got added up. That made the second wave of internet to be connecting about 2 billion people. But most interestingly, as Internet of Things came by, now the devices being connected from anywhere, on any system, from any patient, a patient have hundreds of them, now you have connectivity of things and not any longer people. And as a result of that, what you see is that the connectivity is predicted to be 20 billion by 2020. So therefore, in case of Internet of Things, you see it's no longer you're connecting people, but you're connecting stuff. We have now applications where you have even material being connected on the internet. Material becomes intelligent with a sensor on top of it, can communicate with machines thereafter to see how they can be worked on. And finally, we can also see that even consumer objects, disposables, have the ability to get connected on Internet of Things.